hello to all our undergraduate researchers. As much as I wish I could be there with you in person today, I think that this online format is really a powerful way of your showing what you've accomplished to your colleagues, to your friends, to your family, and to the world at large. At this particular moment in time, it is so clear how important discovery and research is. It's the work that's taken place in our labs right here at the University of Washington, and quite frankly, in labs throughout the world that have been able to inform the policy that has allowed us to flatten the curve and that has literally saved lives. There is no moment in time that I can think of where the importance of research and discovery is clearer. I want to acknowledge that for many of you, being able to continue your research and bring it to this point of presentation has been done while you've been facing some very, very difficult obstacles. And that's been part of your learning as well. And so I want to thank you for your perseverance, for your resilience, and for keeping on. I also want to thank all the faculty, postdocs, staff, and graduate student mentors who've been so instrumental in making these presentations possible. You're part of this important and, in fact, sacred tradition. As teachers and mentors, you not only transfer knowledge, you inspire, you spark the curiosity. You form part of the chain that extends human understanding from one generation to the next. It's always a pleasure for me, if you excuse me and let me brag a little, to say that the University of Washington, again, for 3 years in a row, has been rated the very top, most innovative public university in the country. Some of you may have come here exactly for that purpose, because you knew that you could engage in the creative process, in the research process that we're going to see today. It also helps us draw new students into that chain and into that future. And it is so fabulous to see your work will be not only coming to conclusions, but also inspiring new bodies of research. And it's across every discipline imaginable. Yes, it's about population health. And there is no better moment for population health than right now, where we understand very clearly how the health of any one person actually becomes the health of every person. But also, computer science and engineering, we would not be able to be as connected as we are. We would not be able to do these presentations if it weren't for the advances in those areas. And the arts, they inspire us. They've helped us be connected during this difficult time. Every kind of research, social science, humanities, are part of this incredible tradition of teaching, learning, discovery, and change, of making the world a better place. Congratulations to all 859 students who are presenting their work today and the 707 mentors who've provided you with help and guidance. You represent all three of our campuses, as well as some of our community and regional colleges, and we welcome you to our presentations today as well. Thank you for being flexible and creative in moving your presentations to this online format, and thank you to everybody, faculty, staff, family, and friends who have encouraged, coached, and cheered on our students. A love of research is what started me on my journey, so this is incredibly personally satisfying and personally meaningful for me. I can't wait to see what you have to teach us. Thank you.
I'm happy to add my congratulations to our undergraduate presenters, welcome them, their mentors, friends and family, faculty and students and staff to this year's Undergraduate Research Symposium. It's a virtual symposium this year. We're so glad you're spending time with us today, so welcome. I too want to thank President Cauce for your warm and enthusiastic welcome. You're always such a wonderful supporter of undergraduate research. You've walked with us every step of the way over the years in supporting the undergraduate research program, and it's no different today, so thank you. I'd also like to thank our presenters, mentors, and staff for rolling up their sleeves to create this virtual symposium. We talk about flipping the classroom, which is hard enough in teaching, but to flip a symposium is something altogether different. So our staff approached this challenge with their hearts and a mindset of wanting to create a meaningful professional opportunity for students who have worked so hard on the research for so long. While some of us may be participating via phones, trust me, nobody's phoning this one in. This event really shines a light on what the university does best. We engage in teaching, research, mentorship, the dissemination of knowledge, the search for truth, and disseminating knowledge for the public good. And that's exactly what we're doing here. We see the importance of this every day with complex issues like population health as a prime example. Through their research, undergraduates are writing code to develop maps and more effectively get vaccines to under-resourced parts of the world. They're understanding more about infant mortality, disparities in people's health based on their gender, race, or where they live. And they're helping us understand how art and humanities are also critical to the health of populations. We're proud to partner with the UW's Population Health Initiative, which has selected 12 undergraduate research projects for its fourth round of Population Health Initiative Recognition Awards. You can learn more about that by visiting symposium.uw.edu. I'm proud of the way UW mentors welcome students into their research spaces and for the way students dive into the opportunity. It's nothing short of really inspiring. When I hear the words, "my research is about," those are the words that inspire me the most, because it means that mentors and faculty have passed the research on to students. Students are engaging in that research and they're owning that research. So they say the words at the beginning of their presentation, "my research is about." Those words just inspire me. It means that they've changed their mindset. It means they have a change in their confidence, in their mastery. Students are transformed by engaging in research, and I'm excited for them. For today, students who pre-recorded their presentations will be in the Zoom room for Q&A after their presentation. I encourage you to ask questions, hear their research story, and then be social. Share what inspired you on social media and use the hashtag UWSYMP. Wherever you're attending from today, we're all together supporting students. We're supporting their creativity, we're supporting their scholarship, and we're supporting their research. Have a wonderful day, and thank you for joining us.